Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure to have you.
A pleasure too, as always.
So, who is Big J?
Big J is an artist. Big J is an MC. Big J is a radio presenter.
What?
Big J is a marketer.
And the list continues.
And the list continues.
Those are too many things. How do you multitask?
You know, in life,
yes.
As a man,
yeah.
Wanasema kwamba mwanaume ni kajasho.
Yes.
So if you sit at home, you won't achieve what you want.
Exactly.
So you need to go out there, and if you're given an opportunity, you need to utilize
it. To grab it and use it.
So I started as a gospel musician.
Yes, yes, yes.
And as days went by,
mm-hmm.
but the reason why I started gospel music, yes, I was in church.
Mm-hmm. But when was that? No, don't tell me you don't remember.
No, I'm trying. Okay, I started recording my music in 2006.
What pushed you to record that music?
I wanted my music to play on radio.
Uh-huh. And what happened?
It played on radio.
Uh-huh.
So it was like I was satisfied.
It played on radio.
It played on radio.
Does it still play on radio?
It does.
Uh-huh.
It does. But because what I wanted was that my music plays on radio.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt that I have achieved what I wanted.
Mm-hmm. When the music was playing.
When the music played.
Yes.
So I sat down and thought, what do I really want?
Uh-huh.
When you're in school, as in you're in high school.
So in 204 you're still in high school.
In 206, I was in high school.
Oh,
just
God.
Around here.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
I'm
2006.
I'm not that young.
No, by the way, you're young. That's why I'm laughing.
Okay,
so I'm older than you. Okay, yeah, 2006, you recorded music. It played on radio and you're still in high school.
I was in high school.
How did it feel like you're in high school and your music is playing on radio?
Wow. I can't explain that feeling.
So you are a celebrity. I can imagine the hype in school.
In town, I was one of the biggest musicians.
What?
And to make things worse or better,
uh-huh.
I came with a new style in town.
Mm-hmm.
I was the first guy doing Luya gospel rap.
So, can you do the karap kiasi?
Mahuwa ke kusibala esese nganata, humoleha yesu esese nganata, ese manile yesu nieta.
Yes, your music is still playing. I know that song. I've heard it several times, but I didn't know that was your song.
That was
I'm even
song.
Surprised.
That was
good music. Good music.
Everybody loved it.
Mm-hmm.
But as I told you, not that I did it for money or
yes.
I did it for what, but I wanted my music to play. But
so,
I knew God.
Yes.
That I wanted to serve him. But I thought of something else or what I can serve God better than just doing music. And remember, by that time, we had so many challenges. Your music to play on radio was like a privilege.
Exactly.
Because we had a few radio stations.
Yeah,
by
yeah.
That. And
like now.
And like now, you can take...
Radio stations are blooming everywhere.
In Western Kenya.
And now we have TV stations as well.
TV Magharibi.
Yes.
Yeah, so that is how I did... my music in 2006. I recorded in 2006.
Do you have a video out or you've never even bothered to do a video?
That's the reason why I'm saying I just did my music to play on radio, so I never thought of my music playing on TV.
So that means it wasn't like a calling for you to do music, because if it was, I believe right now you could have done videos.
Yeah, sure. I want to believe that was not my calling.
Mm-hmm. So what's your calling?
My calling was talking to people.
Talking to people. But
that's
not through music.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
That's why I started by saying I'm an MC, I'm a radio presenter.
Uh-huh,
now
exactly.
My calling was talking to people. But when I was in high school, I didn't know how to do it.
Mm-hmm. And now what can you tell just right there? When you were high school, you didn't know exactly what you wanted.
Yeah.
You were like kind of confused.
Sure.
What can you tell high school students who are watching you? Maybe they are in the same situation.
What I can tell these young guys who are in school is that when you're in school, read.
Mm-hmm.
Just read. Because when you bring in so many things,
yes,
you'll be confused. Just like I was by that time.
So what happened after Form 4?
Before Form 4, I dropped out.
What?
When I was in Form 2. Just at Namachanja High School. Just at school around town.
So you dropped out.
I dropped out.
Reason?
But there's
you are a celebrity. You didn't see the need of.
I wanted to do my music everywhere.
Yes.
That's why I say I never knew.
Yeah.
How I could do it.
Yes.
I wanted to talk to people, but now okay, music is here. Go out and talk to people through music.
So there's no need for.
For school.
So read. High school students.
High school students in school, just read.
Okay, let's go for a short break. When you come back, we continue from where we've just left.
You
have now dropped from high school in Form 2.
Sure.
Shikilia hapo. Let's go for a short music break. When you come back, mix from DJ Viano on the other side of the studio.
But I love the music.
You love the music.
Love the music.
He's
the best DJ.
Yes,
in
around
Kenya.
By the way, he's
sure.
The best.
Yeah.
You can tell by the kind of music he's playing.
Sure.
And the mixing.
Uh-huh.
I hope one day he's going to teach me how to do it.
And me too. But right now I know what I want. Now,
but you,
I
you have a lot on your list. I don't think you need to add something.
That's why I said by now I know what I want. So I cannot
go into DJing, maybe just for fun.
Just
okay,
fun.
Let's continue
sure.
Where we had left from.
Mm-hmm.
So, you had dropped out of high school?
Yeah, I dropped.
In Form 2?
In Form 2.
Yes, to do music.
I dropped out of high school to do music,
mm-hmm.
and I did it for 1 year. And I was taken back to school by my mom.
Mm-hmm.
I love my mom.
She I'm
was
telling
a
you.
A mom
yes.
is a different species.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. There's
you're talking to one.
Yeah.
A mom to be.
Yeah, moms are good.
So I'm a different species.
Yeah.
All women are going to be mothers at some point
mothers.
In their lives.
Mothers, yeah. I love single moms, eh?
Yes.
Because they are the best moms.
And they are very hardworking.
Sure. So my mom took me back to school.
After a year?
Yeah. Back from the Machanja High School.
Yes.
Yeah.
Back to Form 2 or Form 3?
Back to Form 2.
Uh-huh. Then continue the story.
So, even after going back to school,
mm-hmm.
I continued doing recording music.
Uh-huh.
I did a song called Nisamehe.
Nisamehe.
So Nisamehe after I went back to school.
Uh-huh.
So the song Nisamehe talks about my life after dropping out.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, and I was through with high school in 2008.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I
just the
my
other day.
Just the other day.
2008.
Sure.
Maybe I was somewhere in college.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That aside, it's not about me. It's
uh-huh.
about you today.
Yeah.
Yes. So now, after high school.
After high school, I went to Eldoret.
Mm-hmm. Now you moved from Bungoma.
From Bungoma
to Eldoret.
To Eldoret.
For green pastures.
Uh-huh. Before that, I had a good relationship with Fish FM. Fish
yes.
FM is a
uh-huh.
station, a gospel radio station in Eldoret. Now, after Form 4,
mm-hmm.
I went to them and they took me in.
As?
As a presenter.
So immediately after high school?
After high school.
You became a radio presenter.
A gospel radio presenter. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
That was in November 13th. I had finished my Form 4 November 11th.
Uh-huh.
So November 13th, I had a chance of going on radio.
2 days later, after high school.
2 days later.
God
now,
loves you. God loves you. You don't know how many people out there are hustling after high school.
Wanafanya kazi ya kutafuta kazi.
Imagine, wanafanya kazi ya kutafuta kazi. Mtu anatembea mpaka kiatu inaisha.
Maze, ni God.
So, ni God.
Ni God.
God loves you.
He does.
Uh-huh.
Now, I went to Eldoret and I started doing a show called Youth Bash.
Youth Bash.
Yeah.
What was it all about?
It was about the young people,
mm-hmm.
talking to the young people and bringing young people to Christ.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I did. Yeah.
You did it for like how long?
2008 to 2009 September.
And then?
I moved to Nakuru.
Huh? And you're going far, far away from Bungoma, like you're in Bungoma the next time you're
Eldoret,
and then you go to Nakuru.
Nakuru, yeah.
Uh-huh.
To Nakuru, it was to go to another radio station.
Yes.
I had been called to a radio called Radio Mwananchi.
Mm-hmm.
Radio Mwananchi is a radio station in Nakuru, so I had a chance of, you know, going to do a gospel show there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so.
And is it like something you always wanted to do or you just stumbled upon?
That is what I wanted.
So you realized that's what you wanted.
That is what I wanted. That's why I say in secondary school, yes, I never knew what I wanted.
You were kind of confused.
I felt that I wanted to talk to...
To people.
To people.
So you wanted a medium through which you can use to reach people.
That's the thing.
Uh-huh. So now, you are at Wananchi, right?
Yeah, I was at Radio Wananchi, mm-hmm, in Nakuru. I worked there to 2010, mm-hmm, in December.
Yes.
2010. Mm-hmm. And somebody came to me and told me, hey, Big J, you know, you're working and you're doing this, but do you have any papers? Mm-hmm. Then I came to realize that lazima usome.
Yes.
Ndio upate kitu unataka.
Shule ni lazima. Shule ni lazima.
Yeah. So if ukisema kwamba you don't go to school.
Mm. Anything can happen.
Anything can happen.
Yes. And
tomorrow,
then you get
the
bosses fired.
Come, yeah, and tell you when you were fired.
Uanze kutafuta kazi.
Na kazi ya kutafuta kazi. Na
kwanza kama at least umefanya kazi,
yeah,
then sasa nakwambia, I can just imagine.
So that was the thing.
Mm-hmm.
So in Nakuru,
yeah,
2010 in December, there's a guy who came and told me, a friend of mine.
Mm-hmm.
He told me, Big J, you are working, you have the money, but do you have papers? Then I was like, enyewe, I need to go to school.
Mm-hmm.
But sasa na huo jana, with the money, nimekula
imeisha.
Sija invest.
Inaingia ikitoka.
Inaingia ikitoka.
Uh-huh.
Then, nika realize sina pesa. So I had to call my mom.
Again, you have to go back to your mom.
Nikaambia mali, I want to go to school.
Mm-hmm.
Mama kaniambia, but you're good in media.
Yes.
But I want you to do marketing,
mm-hmm,
when you go to college. I want you to do marketing.
So your mom wanted marketing, you wanted radio.
Media, I wanted radio.
Yes.
Paka nikatafuta fare, niende Mombasa. Mombasa Polytechnic. Niende niulize fee structure yao nipewe.
Yes,
paka
ni pesa ngapi?
Pesa paka ya admission.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I paid.
Mm-hmm.
So what I wanted is just to tell my mom, tuition fee
ni hii.
Nitumie mimi nianze kusoma.
Yes.
My mom said no. Kwanza ukienda Mombasa, mtoto wangu huwezi enda Mombasa.
Yes.
Alafu akakuwa back to na my sisters.
Uh-huh.
So
uko na siblings wangapi?
We were six, but one passed away.
Oh, me. Yeah. Ashi so, orahi.
Ashi.
May she rest in peace.
Mungu ailaze mahali pema.
Peponi.
Yeah.
Okay.
So in Mombasa, I went to Mombasa Polytechnic,
yes.
Now it's called, I don't know, Kenya, you know, Kenya Poly or something. No,
mm-hmm,
there's this other name, Technical of Mombasa.
Yeah, changing of polytechnics to universities to whatever,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so I was there, I paid the admission fees and
yes,
everything, so I called my mom, when I'm in Mombasa,
yeah,
and I told her, Mom, I'm in Mombasa and I would like you to at least, you know, send me the tuition fee so that I can start. Mpaka nikuwa nimetafuta nyumba bana.
Yani uko ready unangojea tu pesa and then you start.
My mom said, no, you're going to Eldoret Polytechnic.
To do marketing.
She already sent my sister to Eldoret Polytechnic to inquire
yes,
and pay the admission fee and everything.
Yeah.
But I did not want. So from Mombasa, I went straight to Kisumu Poly.
Yes.
You understand?
Yeah.
I never wanted anything to do with Eldoret.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to Kisumu Poly and tried to inquire. They told me they are not offering media but
classes,
they are offering marketing.
Yes. Uh-huh.
But that was January.
Yeah.
But they'll start offering that marketing from May.
Mass communication.
Yeah, no, marketing.
Marketing.
In Mombasa. Oh. Now in Kisumu.
In Kisumu.
Yeah.
In May. Marketing.
So I was trying as much as possible to avoid Eldoret.
Yes.
But my mom insisted. Mm-hmm. So nimebeba mzigo wangu, nimefika Kisumu. Nimeambia mama niko Kisumu, aliniambia no, back to Eldoret. Na ilikuwa ni kitu saa 10 jioni.
Yeah, that's
so
how mothers are.
To LD,
yeah.
And I started my course in marketing.
Uh-huh.
I did it from 2011 to 2012.
Uh-huh.
And I did my course and nikamaliza.
Uh-huh.
But sasa shida iko kutafuta kazi.
Shida iko.
Ndio naambia wazazi wasilazimisha watoto kufanya.
Yeah, by the way, sipo kulazimisha mtoto. Sometimes kitu yenye unataka kufanya,
sure,
you do it better.
Yeah.
And you do it with passion.
Na mtoto akitaka kufanya, kwa mfano, akitaka kufanya utangazaji,
mm-hmm,
atajua bina atamaneuver around.
Yes.
Mwenye atajua kujituma.
Yes, exactly.
Lakini wakati wenye tuko sahii si kama kitambo,
mm-hmm.
whereby your dad or your mom could call somebody in office.
Eh, mtoto wangu anakuja mpatie kazi.
You see,
gone are those days.
Yeah, these days, mtu anajitakia.
Yes, ni msukumo.
So I would like to tell parents that when your son or your daughter wants to
do something.
Yeah? Just allow them.
Yes.
Usikuwa tu wewe ni mwalimu, sasa lazima watoto wako
wakuwe walimu. Haya, shikilia hapo hapo. Remember, we're still here with Big J. We are continuing with our one-on-one. And if you want to talk to him, if you want to interact with him, you can hit us on our Twitter handle, which is at Sifika TV. Or you can reach us on Facebook at Sifika TV Show. We'll go for another short break.